I'm going to douse for water and I'm going to use either a V-shaped rod. This V-shaped rod is made up of copper, or I'll be using an L-shaped rod to continue its definition. Okay. This both rods are made by me only. Okay. Let us see how to find it, and let us see how the forces of this work on. Okay. See, first I'm using a V-shaped rod. See, in this, when you see that, the forces will work on your rod. Okay. This not exceptionally, the rod gets anything, but your hand gets a vibration. Due to that vibration, this turning effect is got. This normally, when you see that, it gets in rotation such that you get the outside force and you are leaving this force like this. Okay. If you take the force inside your body, it will affect your body, it will affect your brain system or your heart also. Okay. See, the same way this copper rod, see, the tension of the rod depends upon your vibration. See, okay, this is very hard such that you get your hands in this and this will be very hard to move it. Okay, this is an L-shaped rod where you can see that it works on crossing of this two rods. See, at what path the water is there, this rod has been crossed. According to me, this is better than that. The forces is got between the rod and it is cancelled between the rod. Let us take this as a positive rod and negative rod. When it moves, the forces are cancelled within this itself. Okay. But not in a V-shaped rod. It does not get cancelled. So you have to be very careful on that. Okay. So be careful while using a V-shaped rod. This is how you divine for water or other minerals.